Why something's up. Let's start out here. This is the most unexplainable piece of Purvis's work to me. When I first saw this work, I looked at it and I said, okay, this is the white Jesus, you know, there's 12 disciples. And I thought that this is just an abstraction over here. And then I started to ask people about it and look at it myself too, and I realized that half of these guys haven't even gone through this in their mouth. And then I realized, well, no, these are Purvis's good people that are going on here. And someone pointed out, he said, that's not a white person. Those are African-American facial figures in it. So I really don't know. And the blood going on in these people is just a fascinating, large piece.
Some of them seem to have halos, though. So maybe they are representative of some
the religious was a very good people.
Yeah, exactly. Religious figure.
Yes, I mean, it gives me a religious feeling.
Yeah.
I just love it as a work of art. Just the major piece. See that one over there? No, it's a carpet.
It's a carpet.
The Purvis puts on everything. Yeah, everything. It's on the carpet. Yeah. These are some of the early pieces you'll see by the dates. I mean, it's really hard to tell if they're threes or sixes or what.
Yeah.
You see a little piece like this. A white man wouldn't really understand this. I certainly wouldn't in the beginning. But this is what black people did in the South. You know, years ago, they encoded their messages so that the white man wouldn't understand what they were saying. See what these are? These are locks. Okay, these are the fetters that the white man, the codes that he puts on the black man, they're being thrown off. It's all about hope. But yet, when you look at that, there's nothing that shouldn't be there. Every line, every movement, it's just genius to me to be able to do something like that. Yeah, I just think it's just a real gem. just a total jewel. Yeah, that really is one of my favorite pieces of his work. If you